Do you know what is the meaning of responsive design? Or do you know how to design a responsive screen in PowerApp? Hi, this is Krupali from KnowHow Academy. So let's start with me. So let me tell you what we are going to do in this video. Here is the screen and I need to create this screen as a responsive screen. Now, what is the meaning of responsive screen? Responsive screen means when I change the size, height or width of the screen, whatever data is displaying on the screen, it will automatically adjust according to the size of the screen. Now let me show you whether this screen is responsive or not. Now see, here in this right side, three options are there: tablet view, phone view and the browser view. So let's check it how it will look in tablet screen. So when you click on that, different tablet options or different tablet resolution you can see. So let me click on that. Now see, my screen is showing like this. If I select this, now see, this side of information is cut. Now let's say if I change to mobile view, let's say Apple iPhone 8, my data is not displaying properly in that type of screen. When I rotate this screen in that vertical view, header and detail information, I cannot see it properly. So this screen design is not responsive. So how responsive screen will look? Let me show you in another screen. Now this is the same screen which display the employee information. Here left hand side, all employee information is there. In middle of the screen, I'm displaying the employee detail information which I am selecting. So let's try out for the tablet. Now see, when I click on that Apple iPad Air 2022, my screen is adjusted according to that. Now let's say if I select any other tablet, okay, you can see like that. You can give your custom width and custom height also. So here, whether I'm changing to any size of tablet, my screen is displaying properly. Automatically, it will adjust the screen height and width, or it will automatically adjust the canvas height. Let me check it for mobile screen. So let's say I'm selecting this mobile. Now see, the header, left hand side employee information and what it is displaying, it is what the detail information that employee has, it displaying in proper. Now this is the horizontal view. Let's check for the vertical view. Now see, the height and width of that, see, automatically it is adjusting like that. So how you can design that type of responsive screen in PowerApp? So today we are going to see how you can design responsive screen in PowerApp. So here is the screen, you can see that. So this is not responsive design. So how we can create a responsive screen? So for that, you need to click on new screen, and here you can see the different designs are available. So this is a slide bar like screen. Now you can see here how it will look in tablet and how it will look it into mobile. So both preview options you can see. So let's say I'm selecting this. When you select this screen, default elements are added. Now what is the meaning of this screen container? So container is basically a kind of control which can hold some control inside that. So when you click on the screen and when you expand that, this is the main container. So you can check it out that this is the main container. Now inside that main container, they have taken one container, that is header container. So header container, so you can put your header information here. Now here below that, they have given a bottom container. So bottom container, it's a kind of left hand side, you can display the employee information. And here in the middle of the screen, you can display the detailed information of the selected employee. Okay, and when you click on that bottom container, two container they are given. So this is a first container and this is the second container. And both container, it's again inside the bottom container. So this way, your screen is designed. So that type of screen, if you take, that is automatically considered it as a responsive screen. Now we have taken a screen. but how we can add element in the screen. So let's say if I'm selecting the screen and I'm displaying, I'm taking here label, so that label I can adjust. But see, that label is not inside the container. So when you save it, save the screen, and when you run it, and let's check it for the canvas size, and let's check it. Now see, you cannot see the label which you have taken. Why? The reason is that the label which you have taken, it is not inside the main container. So you cannot take control directly, select the screen and edit. So let me remove it first. First of all, where, in which container you want to add the control, that you need to select it. So let's say I want to add the container, or you can say I want to add the control inside that header container one. So you can click here on a plus sign, and here you can select any of the control which you want to take. So now see, here I have designed a screen which is not responsive, but I want to create the same copy of that screen. So here I am displaying the information in a label. So here let me click on that and take a label. So insert. So text label automatically put inside that header container. Now that label you want to move it to the center. So if you directly drag that, you cannot remove it, or you cannot make it by dragging it a center align. So for that, you need to click on header container and go for this property screen. So here you can see the direction of the container. So by default, the direction of the container is horizontal container. Okay, so I don't want to change it. But justify horizontal. Justify horizontal means whatever element you are going to add in that container, how it will. So it will look it in like that, middle of the screen. But see, it is top side. I wanted it a center align from the top to bottom and from left to right. So you can select that middle part, or you can select that. Okay, if you select this, the text will, you can see how it will look. Okay, left align, right align, whatever. So I like this, so I'm selecting this. Okay, and then if you double click in on it, automatically label, you can edit it. So let's say here I'm editing the label information, employee information or employee data. So label is added. The formatting options are same. So let's say if you want to give a color to that, you can give proper color. And now see, this employee data and the background of that label is like that. So you can click on that container and you can give color to that container, so it will look like that. Okay, now let's say you want to add one more label here, this side. So how you can add that? So if you click here and if you click here text label, automatically it will insert after the first label. Or there is another way that, let's say you, let me remove this, sorry, not rename this, let me remove this control, delete it, and let's say if you select the screen and you are inserting the label, so again it will insert outside the container. So don't do this mistake when you are designing with the container. So select that container in which you want to add the information. So header container, and inside that you want to put the, let's say again, second label. Now second label you cannot directly move that. So what you can do, you can see when you select that, both will look like that. When you select that, you can see like that. Okay, now see, this label you want to make it left aligned. So select that particular label and let me just select that particular label. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, and just make it left align. Okay, center align, it will look like that. And here you can increase the gap, let's say 10, so it will adjust according to that. Okay, and let's say horizontal flow, you can scroll it. Scroll it means if multiple things are added, it will scroll. Okay, and you convert overflow. If you want to hide it, you can hide it. Okay, horizontal flow, vertical flow, edges. Then align in container. So let's say you can do like that, you can do like that, you can do like that, and by default it will look like this. So you can adjust the size or whatever controls you can edit, but remember, select the prop container and then insert it. So I don't want the label now, so let me delete this. Now in this container I want to make I want to insert gallery control. So select that side container, insert vertical gallery. So automatically gallery will be exist according to the size of that container. And here let's say I want to add a form, so edit form, I'm adding it. Okay, and here in the data source option I'm selecting the employee data which I have given, and then I'm selecting only title and subtitle. I don't want to see the employee image and everything, and I want to see the employee department in which he is working and he or she is working, and employee email ID. So you can see that. Now in the middle of the form, sorry, in the middle of the screen I have added the form. So in form property I need to adjust, I need to select the data source, that is form. Now I don't want only that type of field, so I'm adding the fields, let's say department, division, date of birth, email ID, employee email, then employee status. So you can select any of the field, whatever you like according to that. Okay, and let's say I don't want this created on, so let me remove it. So that type of information I want to see that. And when I select on that particular gallery control, it will show this particular employee information in that. So I need to go to the item property of that, and here I need to write gallery. So which gallery? Gallery 3 dot selected. Okay, and just save it. So whatever you have selected, you can see that. Okay, so let's run it. Okay, now let's first convert it into a canvas size. Okay, now see, that is in a canvas size. If you do it window size, how it will look. So let me back to canvas size, then test for the tablet view. It can adjust the size and test it for the any mobile view. Okay, let's say Samsung Galaxy I'm selecting, and you can see that. And also you can adjust that. Okay, so whatever information you can see, what here detail information, you can check it out. So this way you can design a responsive screen in PowerApp.
Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source of IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out us. It has been a pleasure to share this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.